for whatever you need to haul. I-39 Supply has over 200 trailers in stock at all times with new loads arriving daily. Plus a full parts and service department to keep your downtime to a minimum. Plus, I-39 Supply now offers a full service in-house graphics department for vinyl wraps and decals. Cash, check, credit card, or financing, I-39 Supply says haul yeah to all forms of payment. 5 miles south of Portage, easy on off from the interstate. Visit I-39Supply.com to learn more.
This is the JJO Morning Show podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
Four teenagers were taken into Madison police custody following the theft of a vehicle rollover crash Monday night. Lieutenant Jennifer Hanna, two first names, said an off-duty officer reported a black Kia SUV being driven recklessly on Seven Nations Drive around 8 in the p.m. The SUV was doing burnouts and nearly striking parked cars. Can only be one explanation, and that's a bunch of asshole teenagers.
Yeah, I'm flying. I'm definitely flying through the air.
As officers started to head over to the area, they received information about the same vehicle being involved in a rollover crash in the 2900 block of Foxwood Trail. MPD said the SUV struck an unoccupied van, causing the rollover. Both vehicles were badly damaged.
Jesus.
All of the people in the SUV ran away before police got there, and that's how you know they're teenagers. If they were older, you'd have to lay there for a minute and be like, God, just give me a second. Oh. They were located and detained shortly after, just down the road from where the crash happened. Police said all four suspects are under the age of 15.
Oh, wow. Just 15.
Mm-hmm.
In a way, I'm impressed at the stupidity.
Right.
It's just the lack of
caring.
Any kind of responsibility at 15. It's just, that's incredible.
Now, I ain't going to sit here and pretend like I didn't steal my parents' car when I was 14. Because I did, a lot. But they were sleeping, and I did it at night, and I brought it back, and it was always fine.
Right.
And not that that makes it better, but at least it's not a stranger's car, and I'm not taking out a bunch of vehicles. And I did not want to get caught, and I did not want to wreck that car, that's for sure. The kids, of course, not injured in the crash because their bones are malleable. The owner of the stolen SUV still had the damn keys to her vehicle. She's standing in the parking lot like, what?
I'm out of cars work.
Officials said the suspects were able to manipulate the steering column and steal the vehicle without a key.
What?
But wait.
There's more.
Police say a car theft trend that's well known in other parts of the states is becoming common in Madison. Officers say they've seen an increase in thefts in the area of East Wash Ave and Hayes Road. The thieves are targeting Kias and Hyundai.
Yeah. The summer of Kia. I saw that story in Milwaukee. They did. Yeah, they're easy to steal.
I guess so.
Yeah, that's the key. We ought to do a thing with teenagers and put them in, you know, these county fairs where they have the demolition derby?
Yes.
We ought to have the little, I'll think of a good name for it, but for these little a-holes and let them go out there and crash into each other and
get
it out of their system.
Over there with their GPS bracelets on.
It's like Hunger Games. We just put 10 teenage assholes in a ring and one man leave.
Yeah, I see.
And you don't get a helmet.
Whatever. If you got a Kia or a Hyundai, I would put a freaking second layer of protection on that thing.
In all honesty,
Jesus,
I was trying to think back to my parents, who had a pretty good bead on me. And my shenanigans.
As in they beat you?
No. I mean, a grasp of my mental stability.
Oh.
I mean, I was pretty close to my mom, so she knew. She kind of knew what was going on. And she knew who I was out with and what that meant. If that makes sense to
you.
Yeah. She had her bad egg. She did not. She knew that was going to be a problem that I'd hang out with. But I'm still a little surprised that a parent doesn't have a little better idea what their kid's up to. I know that sounds naive and stupid.
No.
But
I mean, I'm curious too. Where is the family? What's happening? Are the parents working? You know, is mom out at her job and the kid is needs somewhere to go after school? You know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Like, my mom knew when I was when I tried smoking cigarettes. She found out. She knew immediately.
Oh, my parents didn't have a clue about anything. Not a damn thing.
And I like it that way. I'm 40 years old, and I want to keep it that way.
The only time they knew things were up, I remember one night, me and Marty Prem.
Yes.
From Prem Meets.
Marty the one-man party.
I think we were 16 or so. And I don't know why we were drinking in the haymow, but we were. And I remember we had like a stack of beer cans by the door.
Nice.
And so when my dad came to get me, I don't remember if I had to work or if I had chores or whatever.
And this is like the 9 o'clock hour here on this show. Oh. Nothing's changed.
The whole tower of beer cans came down.
Oh, no.
And he's like, "You both drinking here last night, huh?" And we were like, "Yeah." And then he was like, "Marty, you're going to have to give me some of them cigarettes." And then we went about our day.
Lady Littlemare, you going to make an honest woman out of my daughter?
We're only 12, sir.
I know, you make an honest woman. You give me them smokes right now, I'm going to beat you to death.
How old were you?
Like 16.
Well, 16, you're on the you're on the cusp.
Yeah, but I was, that's pretty much it.
End of that car, say the Kia, was not in a garage.
No, I don't know where the hell it was at. Right.
Well, a lot of people in apartments can't.
Right.
They don't have access to a garage. But, man, I'm a man, dude. It's just so frustrating.
Yeah.
Little, and it always ends the same way. It's weird teenagers don't...
You'd think they could drive better. There by must now. Be.
Well, these are just the ones we hear about.
Oh yeah.
What about the car? What about the people getting away with it?
I know.
And just leaving a car somewhere.
Well, I know somebody again who had their car taken and they got it back and there was no damage on the inside. Yeah, and yeah. I was like, "Well, you're lucky."
Yeah.
I'm like, because a lot of times they just trash the inside of it.
Again, naive on my part. I know. I get it. But it's incredible that the lack of compassion for somebody's property.
Right.
That's a car.
Dude.
It's a big deal.
Right. And I don't... People are very, very selfish.
Beer cans in the barn, drinking beer in the barn, and stealing a car are two different solar systems, dude.
Right. Well, it's like lack of respect for how hard people have to work for things.
Right.
You know what I mean? And if you don't understand how hard people have to work for things, right. You are not going to respect
them. Because you don't own a car yet.
Right.
Correct. You don't own anything yet.
You're 14. Yeah.
He's 14, living like a rock star.
Jesus Christ.
Stealing cars. Man, oh man. It's incredible to me.
It is. It's mind-blowing. But I saw somebody downtown over by East Wash, and she had what's the thing? The club that you put across your steering wheel? Is that what it was?
Yeah.
She had one of those in addition to her regular, security system. So if you have a Kia or a Honda, that might not be a bad idea. An old-school defense system. So... they can't drive off with your freaking vehicle.
No,
Jesus Christ.
For what they do with the car, it makes it even more frustrating. We're just going to do donuts and then just leave it somewhere.
Right. We're just going to beat the crap out of your vehicle.
just going to do hood rat crap and then just walk away.
Well, do you remember I can't even remember what the hell her title was. The lady that worked here, she was in charge of something or other. And the kids came into our parking lot in the morning. Do you remember this?
Oh, I do remember this.
And they took her car.
Yeah. Here. Yeah, it was here.
They went through other people's cars, but they took her car. And the police weren't mad because, wait for it, the kids drove it to school. And I was like, what now? I'm sorry. Jesus Christ.
I didn't remember that part.
Yeah. I'll never forget it.
We'll have this back on Friday. We got to.
I was told that, and I wasn't even able to talk or process it for a while. I'm like,
am I remembering that correctly? Was she a nice older lady?
No.
No.
Well, I mean, she was nice enough. That made right. it so, no, she was a young bitch.
Oh.
No.
Fair enough.
No, she was nice. I don't know, maybe in her 40s or so.
I was thinking of somebody else.
Yeah.
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
And only 3 countries in the world don't use the metric system?
Or you can listen to this one.
I can't remember where I went Friday. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, what did I do on Friday? I got to check my calendar.
If anybody saw me Friday, call.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
I literally have no idea where I was Friday.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
It's time for the JJO Morning Show 640 Sex Fix. Talk dirty to me, please.
Good.
Erika.
Hi.
What's that? How are you?
Oh, I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. What is on your mind?
Well, it's not directly about sex because I don't want to think about my mom having sex, but, yeah, so this is a question about my mom.
Okay, good. We love
I have a few too.
Why did she quit calling? She quit returning my calls. All right, go ahead. Tell us about your mom.
Well, so, just let me preface by saying she is 62 years old. And she is currently dating a 22-year-old.
Yeah! Atta girl. Sure, they have very intense conversations.
Yeah. So,
hey, you want to go steal a car? Let's go steal a car. It'll be great. Okay, go ahead.
I'll put it to you this way. Right now, she is absolutely loaded because she divorced my dad about 5 years ago. And let's just say that he is a well-known doctor in Milwaukee. So, she made out real good in that.
I believe it's Dr. Giannis Antetokounmpo.
He's a doctor.
He's a doctor of slam dunks.
Hey, that's true.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, so anyways, they've been dating for about 6 months now, and, you know, he's driving around in a new truck. They're talking about building a house.
Yeah. Does he have a...
Yeah.
Does he have a gig? What's he do?
Bangs her mom.
Oh, yeah. I've not heard mention of any job.
She took my money.
Oh.
Well, I'm in need.
Oh, hang on.
Yes, it's a trifling friend indeed. Oh, she's a gold digger. Way over town. That digs on me.
Oh. Particularly a male gold digger.
Yes. Male gold digger.
So
I feel like the Orchid Man. I'm here to eliminate a gold digger. I'm going to spray him with my...
I would like to comment.
Yes.
Mind your own business.
Oh, my God.
I know. This is not your department. If your mom, after your pops passed away, wants to go get a deep, dirty... from a young... twit man...
A well-hung twit.
Let her do it. If she wants to keep a kept man, let her do it.
She's earned it.
Yeah.
How miserable.
Men do this all the time.
How miserable was she with your father? I mean, she may have been a very sexual person, and her father might not have been.
Right.
What's your take on their marriage on the last half of their marriage?
Oh, I mean, it was my dad just worked constantly.
Sure,
so,
right.
Yeah, they didn't really see each other very much.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So she probably wants a young, attractive man to pay attention to her nonstop.
Don't we all?
Yes.
I mean, I get that, but if he's, like, spending all of her money, I mean, I guess I'm just, you know, also over here worried about when she's going to, you know, retire. Is she going to have anything left if this guy spends it all?
Yeah.
She's in her 60s. If she doesn't know by now how to manage her money, I don't know what you're going to do about it. But, I mean, you can ask her, be like, hey, do you got something squirreled away in case, you know, dick bag over here takes everything? But dudes do this all the time. 60-year-old men get hot 25-year-old girlfriends and buy them everything they want and take them everywhere, and nobody's like, well, is he okay? You know what I mean?
Why not do a welfare check on Charlie there?
Right.
No, it's a great point. It's a great point. Man, you know the trick I use to keep gold diggers away? You know what I do?
You're poor.
Yeah, I'm broke.
Yeah.
That's how I roll.
Solution.
Like when you now when you say because I'm nosy, ballpark me on the mom's bank account. Ballpark me. What's your best guess?
If best guess, it's like 12 million.
Okay. Has she ever sat on a lesbian DJ's face before? Can we start there?
I saw her first.
I
saw her first. Get over here, Martha. Oh, my Lord.
I guarantee you I can do things I do.
Well, even if she burns out on this guy, it sounds like she might. You think she'd do a prenup if they get married? Are they getting married?
I doubt they're going to get married.
No, they're not.
That would be.
Think they get married?
If they get married, that's when you got to be like, whoa, pump the brakes. I think right now she's just having the time of her life.
I think 12 million, if you think your mother is financially naive, I think that's fair for her to keep an eye out. I think you love your mother, clearly.
Yeah, I do.
$12 million. That's impressive.
Oh, man, we're poor as hell.
We had bad goals.
Yeah, I mean, just a series of bad decisions, really.
Do you and I have $12,000 together? Clearly, we get along because we're broke and we understand each other. Yes. Fighting over the last beer in the refrigerator. Well, what do you want to do? If she's in love, you're stuck. And maybe he'll use it. Maybe he'll be motivated to go start a business or something.
Oh, I don't know about that.
I mean, your mother will own it. Yeah, your mother will own it. But yeah, I mean, clearly, if she's buying the meals, the drinks, and the gifts in the truck, boy, that's a tough one. That's a tough one.
Yeah, I don't want him to bleed her dry, you know?
Right.
I don't think there's much you can do. Do you get along with him? This is really interesting.
I've really only met him a few times. And I mean, he's, you know, like 10 years younger than me.
Sure.
So.
We have nothing in common.
I know. I just want to be around for the breakfast table conversations.
And see, if this is your mother's first round of gold digger-itis, she's just going to have to learn the hard way and then realize that, you know, not everybody's in it for the right reason. I don't know what else you're going to do. What would you... Anything?
I'd just be like, hey, Ma, I love that you're getting some boning in, but let's make sure your retirement's squared away. And
it sounds like your mom didn't go Dutch with homeboy there for the first couple of dates.
Right.
Yeah, no, I doubt it.
And by Dutch, I mean Dutch oven.
I wonder, how did she meet this person? Because there's all those, like, sugar mama, sugar daddy websites.
No.
If she went on one of those looking for some young strange.
Yeah, that's the other shocking part.
You know?
I don't know. According to her, I think they met at a grocery store.
Shut up! That is not what happened. She's lying to you.
I mean, that's what she told me, but...
Right.
Oh my God, he was
a lie. Bagging groceries.
Bagging groceries and it's some tight pants, and your mom just couldn't help herself.
She was like, "You quit your job, come with me." Wouldn't that be amazing?
I'll buy you a truck and move you into a basement, but you gotta walk away.
You gotta cover me in semen.
You gotta.
Sorry, that's your mom. But hey, my mom's that way.
I used to think there was a database for semen at the police station.
There isn't,
but there's not. Man, I don't even. I think your mom's got enough money that maybe she'll. And who knows? If they get married, that'd probably make it worse. But maybe she'll find out eventually that she'll catch him cheating or dipping into the account when he's not supposed to and wanting a second truck. And maybe she'll wake up and smell the asshole. I mean, the the gold.
Yeah, I'm just worried it's going to be too late.
Right. Well, yeah. The only thing you got to watch is if he drains the bank account and leaves the country. I would think that would be the worst case scenario, right?
Well, hopefully she's got her head screwed on well enough that she's not giving him debit cards.
Isn't it fair enough to say, hey, let's set up a separate bank account, your account? I mean, you can share an account if that's how you want to go, but why don't we set something up separately and secretive?
I don't know. maybe just.
I don't know how this stuff works. I don't know any rich people.
Right.
So
I would just approach her from a place of concern. Don't even, you know, I wouldn't.
Right. Don't be.
Don't bring up the dude's age or nothing. Just be like, Hey, I just want to make sure that you got your finances buckled down.
Well, no.
I'm glad that you're having a great time. I'm glad that you're having a great time.
Yep. Let's all go out.
With your young person.
Yep.
Yeah, let's all go out and then, yeah, whatever. But please, I just want to make sure that you have your finances dialed in.
I think it's fair because you get some of that pre-dementia stuff and then you don't, some people, isn't that thing about pre-dementia, you start giving your money away?
I think it's different for everybody.
Muhammad Ali.
Some people actually hide all of it.
Okay. All right.
It can be a real pain in the ass for family members.
Mm-hmm.
Well, good for your mom. I'm happy she's getting a good pounding.
Yeah, right now she's horny and loving life. So in a way, yeah, you appreciate it.
Right.
You know, because it'll keep her happy and youthful. But, I don't know. I don't know. It all depends on your, on that little voice. And I would get to know the guy.
Totally.
I'd stay closer, keep your enemies closer, right? I'd stay closer to the dude and get a bead on him.
Yep.
You know? And then say, hey, look, where'd you get the truck? You know, something like that. Whatever.
Okay.
Weird. All right.
Yeah.
Well, a special, very special situation.
I like this.
Yeah, I do too.
High drama.
I like being nosy.
I know.
$12 million. I'm trying to think right now, this whole conversation, whether I'd have sex with a 70-year-old woman for $12 million.
Hell yeah, I would. Are you kidding me?
I'm thinking I could.
I do with three of them. I don't even care.
Does this house come with a swimming pool? Holy crap. I'll give you a massage, lady. Jesus Christ.
Bring that old Squish Mitten over here.
All right. Good luck. We're on your side. And if that doesn't work out, one call.
Replay today the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and Dee. JJO.
Tell me about your interactions with raccoons.
They're feisty.
You've had encounters.
Yeah.
I too have had an encounter, but it was my own damn fault.
They like to F with our cats. You gotta watch them.
Through the window?
No, like out at the farm.
Oh, okay. I've
had to come to Jesus with a couple of raccoons.
How'd that work?
People thought I was a little crazy.
Yeah, I bet, dude. One of my favorite videos ever is the one of the raccoon. He's got the cotton candy in his hand, and he puts it in the puddle to wash it, and it disappears.
He didn't know.
I know. It kind of makes me sad. I got bit by a raccoon when I was 10.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but it was my own fault. I was trying to feed it.
Yeah.
So
he just got you on the finger.
Yeah. He was like, oh, I'll have that too. Thank you. And then I lied about it. I didn't tell anybody I hit it.
Oh, my God. It was the Christmas Story version of shooting your own eye out.
Yeah. And so I was hiding it.
Interesting.
And then my sister was like, what happened? And I said that the dog bit me. And she's like, that's a lie. What happened? And then I told her. And she's like, I'm not panicking. Everything's fine. And then she got my mom and we went to the emergency room.
Wow. How did raccoon fare?
Not good. He got his head chopped off because they had to send it in for rabies testing.
So you were keeping it as a pet?
No.
Oh.
See, that was the thing, right? Like, it was out during the daytime.
Yeah.
Red alert.
So they caught it.
And then, and it was, it let me approach. Red alert.
How'd they know it had, they caught and beheaded the right raccoon?
Because there aren't a whole lot of raccoons out during the daytime.
All right.
So
he was, he wanted his treats.
Yeah, he was wandering about the property.
See what happens when you mess with nature?
You end up in the ER.
Well, no, I was thinking more about the raccoon. Oh. I really don't care about your finger. You get your head chopped off. I mean, you got 9 more fingers. Shut up already.
Oh, I love it. Anyway, so this story, I get it, dude. Florida woman was taking her dog for a walk when it spotted a raccoon in a tree.
Mm.
The raccoon ended up attacking the dog and then chased them both into her house.
Wow.
She used a broom to scare it into a set of blinds, and the animal control came and took it away. Give me PC2.
Yeah.
He noticed something in the tree, so he stopped, looked up in the tree. The raccoon just raced out of the tree and charged towards us. So at that moment, that's when I started running, trying to get in the house as soon as possible. I was basically in like a panic mode. So at that point, I got a mop and I kind of scared it off with the mop. And then it hid in the blind. And it took them a little minute to come, but once they came, they got him and it was over at that point.
Wow.
Damn, Gina. They can be scary little buggers. Did I tell you about the dog trail? What happened on the dog trail?
Oh, I think I have a raccoon story.
All right.
I think a raccoon got into our camper.
Oh.
And it ate the mothballs. We always had everything when I was a kid growing up smelled like effing mothballs.
Right.
Mom put them everywhere in our closet, our camper, in the car. What was that all about? Mothballs. Anyways.
Because it keeps the mice out.
Right. And I guess the raccoon ate it and then, of course, died and went berserk and there was blood all over the camper. So I'm sure he was thrashing about. Yeah, it was gross. I remember that one. Unless my dad murdered somebody in the camper and blamed the raccoon.
Yeah, nice cover-up, Dad.
My dad was the Zodiac killer. No, I don't know. So that's my raccoon. My big raccoon story.
Damn, nature, you scary.
The coon is a menace.
We were out on my secret trail
mm-hmm.
that I don't tell anybody about because I don't want anybody to be out there.
To this day?
To this day. There's only a few people I've told about it. But people are starting to find out about it, and it irritates the hell out of me.
Secret. It's probably a little patch of woods, and there's probably like 300 pizza boxes out there.
Shh. Why are you like this?
Pizza.
So we were out, and I like it because I can leave my dog off leash.
Oh, this is by your house.
There's no, Jesus Christ, Joan! So we're out walking, and then there's a section of the trail that offshoots to like a creek area. And so he'll go down there, and it's all very relaxed. We're all very relaxed, very nice. And then all of a sudden, it is not relaxing. And they're screaming.
Jeez.
And so I'm running down the trail and it's daytime. Again, raccoons out during the day, never a good thing. And so he has a raccoon in his mouth and he's shaking it like it's a stuffed animal.
Your dog does.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I get him to drop the raccoon and it like moseys over and then it like sits down underneath the tree and it's like, "Mmm." And I was like, oh, no, because we're past regular vet hours. So I'm like, I don't want to call the emergency vet.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
So get him off that section of trail. And he's happier than a pig in snit, dude. He's just like, that was the greatest. Did you see that? I'm like the coolest dog. And so I'm like checking him for bites and anything. Everything looks fine. And I was like, Jesus. And my adrenaline's pumping and whatever. So we get in the truck. And he does the thing where they shake their heads.
Yeah.
Blood everywhere.
Oh, no.
And I'm like, what?
Oh, no.
The very tip of his ear had got sliced open.
Uh-huh.
Which everybody knows, like, that bleeds like a mofo, right? So get him home. You can't wrap that. You ain't wrapping that. That dog is going to get that Band-Aid off, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, again, head shaking, blood everywhere. And then I super glued the sucking thing shut.
Super glued it shut?
I did.
Well, that's what they would have done.
Right. It's exactly what they would have done.
Put some duct tape on it.
Everything was fine.
Move on.
Everything was fine. Then I had to take him in and, well, he had all of his vaccines and stuff. Yeah. So they were like, he should be fine unless you see anything weird.
Little raccoons, man. They're like little bears. They're just, they got a streak in them, man. They stand their ground. They definitely do. I give them credit. They're tough little bastards.
Yeah.
They don't back away from a fight. That's for damn sure.
They're freaky little hands.
Right.
Dumbing down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Are you ready for a break on that friggin' gas price or what?
Oh, where's that happening at?
I'll
spend 10 gallons to drive there to get a break on gas.
Biden said he's nearing a decision on a gas tax holiday, which would pause federal gas taxes. Woo! That could drop gas by about 18.3 cents a gallon, which is a start. We're looking for an announcement by the 4th of July, but I won't care because I'm going to be on vacation when I'm at.
Thanks for sneaking that in there. I appreciate it. Yeah. No, we were just talking about gas the other day. And, you know, now they've got us because now what's gas? $4.77 or something this morning. I mean, you know, went up another dime. Now, if we go back, I told Chrissy last night, I'm like, here's where they got us by the balls. Because now if gas goes back to $3.50, we're going to think it's the greatest deal on earth.
We've already been through this, though.
I know. And I know facilities are shut down, and I get it. I understand all the stuff. And we're importing too much. I get all that stuff. But how good would $3.50 sound right now?
Oh, totally.
Amazing. It's like we're never going back to $2.50. Never going to happen in our lifetime. Got us by the balls.
I thought that too, but then it happened during COVID, right?
Well, sure. Yeah. Well, that's
you never know.
That's an event.
Right.
Sure.
Yes, it's an event nobody wanted tickets for. I was looking for old bits about gas prices, you know, like songs or whatever. And I found this song. It was like a Tesla parody. But it was bitching about high gas prices, and it was $3.05. And I was like, oh, God, we only do.
How great would $3.05 sound right now? Huh?
I know. That was during, it was like 2005. I think it was after Katrina.
It's just
because of the refineries.
Yeah. It's just a...
So... 73% of Americans said they were planning to travel this summer, which is up from 53% last year. People seem to be putting pandemic concerns on the back burner because we're all going to die anyway.
I saw an article. Well, go ahead and finish.
There's a new challenge, the inflation.
Yeah.
The average expected cost of a vacation has gone up from $2,400 to $2,700. I'm spending way too much on our trip to Colorado.
Are you?
Yeah. I mean, I booked the tickets back in February. It's a high travel time. Uh-huh. I mean, whatever, hotels and a cabin and everything else. And oh yeah, I'm definitely at least the 2400 mark.
The 2400 mark.
Yeah. Because it says it's gone up $300 from 2400 to 2700.
Oh, okay.
The biggest surges are in gas and airfare.
Yeah.
But relief could be on the way. Yeah. My airfare was pretty pricey. The exact plan hasn't been revealed because who are we kidding? Nobody knows. Gas tax money goes towards addressing internal infrastructure and ROADs. So the money wouldn't be getting to projects that are depending on it at a local level. So if we do the federal gas tax pause, well, you know, that money dries up. That's how all of this works. Some Republicans oppose lowering gas prices because they feel like it's a political win for them. Senator Rick Scott from Florida recently said that rising gas prices and inflation are a gold mine for the Republican Party. So that should tell you a little something about none of these assholes working for you. None of them! Well, there's maybe like four, but whatever. White House says they're also working at it from the other end, much like I worked on your mom from the other end.
Pow, pow!
Confronting oil companies, which have been raking in record-setting profits.
I'm going to buy me an electric car and vote out a couple of these representatives.
Listen here.
And then I'm never going to leave the house.
Record-setting profits.
Oh, billions. Tripled billions. It's incredible.
It is.
Yeah.
So, hey, if you were worried about the corporations, don't worry. They're doing just fine.
Limited output, higher prices, doesn't matter. Triple billions. Mm-mm. I think, who was the one who went from 2.1? Was that a quarter? Was that a year 2.1 to 9, like 9.5 or something? Was that a BP?
I don't know. I start reading those articles and I have to stop because I just get filled with rage.
They ran an article on RV owners, people with RVs out there. They were showing a guy filling his RV. It got 7 miles to the gallon. It cost him $900 to fill his tanks on an RV. He goes, yeah, we're going to stay a little closer to a campground in the neighborhood.
I would just be taking my RV to the end of the driveway.
No, they're changing the name to Nearcation, I think they're calling it.
Right.
No.
I've done those before, and there's nothing wrong with it.
How about some of the local little campgrounds around here?
Yeah.
Just park your $400,000 motorhome in a local little campground with a pond. Woo!
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
I'd be doing a lot of parking at the Walmart overnight. Just hang out there for a month. What's going on?
God, do you remember when Waylon first started?
Yes.
And hanging out with him in a Walmart parking lot?
Walmart? We would go set up lawn chairs at a Walmart parking lot and sit and hang out with Waylon for the afternoon. Say, we had a hot dogs? I'm going to run on in and get some mustard and hot dogs. Everybody need anything? Y'all good? Need ice?
Yep. Hey, we're at the Walmart. Be like, be right over, dude. Ah, God.
It's like we got a big day planned. On the Planet Fitness, and we're gonna come back to the Walmart hang out for a little bit.
Oh man,
hit the laundromat maybe, shake it up a little bit. Yeah, pretty insane. Don't know what to tell you, man. You're gonna have to. I don't see many people affected by it. I mean, I know, you know, there's people on fixed incomes and stuff, maybe, and I know, but I don't see any less activity.
Well, that's just it
out there anywhere.
Exactly.
So I don't know. I don't think we're at the point where it's a deal breaker yet.
Right. Well,
I don't know what that would be, but
I feel like people would be more inclined to have the less activity thing if we didn't just go through two years of not doing anything.
It's a cruel mistress, biatch, because it seems like we were so, you know, held up by COVID. Now that we're out and moving about the country, we don't care.
Right.
We're willing to pay it.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
Like, well, I'll pay for it later.
Yeah.
I've been doing it for 40 years.
Now, I'm curious. I would like to hear from my restaurant friends. I know that people are tipping less, but I wonder if it's like less traffic in the restaurants overall.
I got to ask you, do you tip for cleaning at a hotel when you leave? Okay. When we were in Vegas for our 25th, we were in the room and we had a checkout and then we had to put the bags in our room because we got late checkout. Yeah. So like three couples brought bags up to our room.
Mm-hmm.
And I pulled out a 20.
Yeah.
And left. We were there for, what were you there, 4 nights?
Yeah, it was a while.
I left a 20.
Yeah.
You're like, what are you doing? I'm like, what do you mean, what am I doing? You don't tip?
I've never been more proud of you in my life.
No, we never tip.
What?
She goes, they get paid. We don't tip hotel cleaning.
You tip hotel cleaning.
Man, the mess we left.
I even organize everything.
Well, you know what I did in your shower? I'm going to leave you $20.
There's semen everywhere. I usually put all the towels by the
underneath the texture. Look at the texture on this bathroom tile. It's wonderful.
Is that popcorn ceiling?
Wait a minute. I was flabbergasted that they said they didn't leave a tip at a hotel
always
room.
Tip.
What happened?
If it's just a few bucks.
What happened to that?
First of all,
I know they don't come in your room that much anymore. I get it. I think we had cleaning once for towels.
We just got towels.
I think all we got was towels.
Yeah.
But it's like that is a pretty thankless job. Behind the scenes that do a great job. I love walking into a great clean hotel room.
Oh,
so not only are you tipping them, you're tipping for what they left you.
Right, exactly.
You know, and took care of your room. And
totally.
Removed the bodies. It is Vegas, by the way.
And
that was pretty shocking to me.
Man, yes, it is shocking. I think some people don't know that they're supposed to tip the housekeeping staff. But, I mean, especially in Vegas, you look at the amount of waste out there.
Yeah.
If you're blowing $18 on a damn cheeseburger, you can leave a 20 for your housekeeper. Okay?
If you're leaving $4,000 in a slot machine.
Right.
I think I can tuck a 20 away.
Come on now.
In my wallet.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. But I'd be curious if traffic overall is down.
I look at these rooms and the mess and the you think about the sheets and I don't know if they use tongs. They come in with a like a bodysuit on. It's like what a not great job.
There's a method to packaging up the bedding.
I'm sure.
Yeah. But yeah, right, totally. I put all the garbage in one place. I put all the towels in one place, either in a corner in the bathroom or whatever. So it's kind of easier for them to go through everything.
So you don't look like a pig. I do that too. I do try to clean up a little bit.
Yeah.
So I don't look like, but I guess it's Vegas and they've probably seen blood on the walls.
Probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
I saw a hangover. I know how everything goes. I know what can happen. Hi, how's it going?
I make sure to tip the hotel people anytime they have to clean up after my son.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
He's just a stinky teenager, and I'm like, if I have to do his laundry and you have to clean the beds, I'm sorry.
I appreciate the fact that they have to deal with the after sex towels that get left on the bathroom under the sink. They know what's on there. They know what's in that towel.
Oh, yeah. Have you ever seen those shows where they, do the blue lights in there?
Oh, yeah. I try not to watch that.
This is ignorance is bliss kind of situation.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, we know, but no.
Right.
I think
exactly.
As far as tipping in the barbering world, the tipping in barbering world is still pretty okay. So.
Okay, good.
Hey, are you changing any travel plans because of gas?
Unfortunately, yeah, we canceled one of our trips.
Really?
Because of it.
Where were you going? Was it a drive or a flight?
I was a drive.
Oh. Where were you going to go?
I was going to go to Tennessee with my son because him and his girlfriend have never left the state of Wisconsin, and apparently that's a big deal.
Wow.
I love you.
So we were going to drive down to Tennessee, but now we're just going
to
go
to Illinois.
And Chicago.
There you go.
Oh, that'll be fun.
Totally.
You know, there's great parks in Illinois.
It'll be a good time.
It'll be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Drive up around Michigan. Go to Grand Haven. And lay on the beach. It's
going down to Dubuque. It's a good drive.
It's like Florida over there, man.
Prairie du Chien.
Love it. Yeah. Yeah, you've got stuff four hours.
Much.
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, well, and I was trying to explain to them that there are so many things fun in Wisconsin to do.
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
You can just drive everywhere. Like, I really want to go up to Green Bay this year and see that Jurassic Park World thing. Have you guys seen that?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
And then when you go, you go up there, there's all kinds of different parks and stuff. And yeah, there's a million things to do in Wisco.
Yeah. And that's what I was trying to explain to him. Like when we were younger, that's what we did. You got in the car, you drove until you didn't want to drive no more. And then just explored the area.
Right. Right. Well,
like, I'm like,
I would,
nothing.
You would know this more than I, cause you camp, cause you're insane. Have you checked on campsites? Or they must be busier than ever, state parks.
I have not checked because we only have one camping trip planned this summer because we're gone so much.
Like Governor Dodge and Prairie du Chien. I mean, Wyalusing. That stuff must be packed.
No, we booked Wyalusing back in like January.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, I was going to say, in January when I was looking for campsites, we were pretty okay. But
just camp on the back. Listen.
The place was supposed to be filled, and it wasn't filled.
Listen, so you can pitch a tent in my backyard. You can stay if that's what it takes.
Well, that's very nice of you. I hope you have enough groceries to feed two teenage children.
You know, just say, oh, I'll put them to work. They're going to be pulling weeds. It'll be fine.
I'm not opposed to that. They can have all the physical labor they need.
All right. Sounds good.
Have a great day, guys.
10-4.
See ya.
10-4.
Hold on a second here. I'm going to check out a campsite quick.
It's funny that we're about to play Seether and Gasoline.
Oh, that is.
Did you do that?
Maybe.
You did not.
I saw it was scheduled, and I was like, well, this is a good time to do my gas price story. So, yeah,
First person I know that's canceled a trip.
Right. Well, a drive to Tennessee is pretty substantial. You know what I mean?
Well, I don't know what they're driving, but...
it don't really matter, does it?
Could be. Well, I don't know. Nashville's 9 hours away. I mean...
Right.
Not, you get something that's got 35 miles of a gallon, you're not too bad, but...
Yeah, but I mean, you're from the time you schedule it, your road trip is increased, you know, whatever, 75%.
No, I mean, it's everything. I mean, we...
Right, and then you're going out to eat and it's more expensive.
We're going up to Michigan here in a couple of weeks. Hotel rooms are more expensive than ever, mm-hmm. like you just said. I mean, what's an average hotel room?
With fees, you're gonna pay about
$400
a night.
Yeah.
No, the average hotel room is like $200 a night.
Nah, no, I'm looking at Nashville. Our hotel
in Nashville.
Our hotel up in Michigan's $320 a night.
Here, look.
It's not even that great of a hotel.
Yeah, no.
But we're going to wine country somewhere.
I'm gonna find my Denver.
But that's it. We're doing that. We're done. I'm gonna take a golf staycation at the Oaks.
So for our stay in Denver, which is we're at the hotel by the airport on our last night. That's $150.
Like a day's in.
La Quinta Inn.
Oh, Suites. Sure. There's an Applebee's right next door.
Right, and then, but I mean, you know, like you stay at Indigo Hotel. That's a $300 a night. Hotel.
Crazy.
Right. It just kind of depends on what and where you're at. But even, because we're in a hotel for the first three nights, and I want to say it was $200 a night. Our hotel room in Minneapolis was $150.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. But I try to find the deals, you know.
It's amazing what type of hotel you get for $150. It's like the murder hotel.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
That's the one that's $75.
Well.
The Millennium Hotel, downtown Minneapolis, is not a murder hotel. La Quinta Inn, that I stayed in here in Madison, was not a murder hotel. Okay?
Okay.
It was actually very nice.
When I see airport hotels, I just think murder hotels.
What is wrong with you?
Well, it's the way it is.
Not every hotel needs to be bougie. That's why you're paying $300 a night, because you have granite countertops in your friggin' bathroom.
And then you're never in your hotel room.
And then you're never in your hotel room.
When I get back, to be in the lap of luxury. All right.
Well, you're so fancy.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and Dee, nowhere but JJO.